Hi everyone. Today we're in the leafy Manchester suburb of Chorlton, just 3 miles from the city centre and home to a wide choice of bars and restaurants. I want to show you what this area has to offer and how it can be the perfect place for a date. First up is Mary and Archie. There are 2 branches, one in Chorlton and one in Didsbury. Let's have a look. Everything can be ordered and paid for here at the table. They have an offer on for 3 small plates for £14, so I've picked a selection with a pint of milk stout and half a pineapple Schafferhofer. The drinks arrive quickly, no queuing up at the bar and no bother. I've not tried this milk stout before. I quite like stout and I think this one's quite nice and easy to drink. I'd recommend it. Of course there's the Schafferhofer. It's slightly sweet, light and smells like pineapples. What's not to like? It's hard to choose which one's best, but I'll pretend to be a grown-up and say that the stout is the best. The food's arrived. Here we have 3 small plates of salt and pepper fried chicken, chorizo and shallots in red wine, and mac and cheese. Yum. The salt and pepper chicken doesn't look like I expected it to, but the portion is quite generous. It looks a bit hairy, but I think it's just ginger fibres? Is that a thing? Ah well, I guess I have to eat it to find out. Wow, it's actually really good. It doesn't look it, but it's a bit crispy with a little kick of heat. Chicken is still tender. I'm happy so far. Mac and cheese. I'm not a massive fan usually, but I thought I'd give it a go. There's a generous amount of cheese and the macaroni looks super hot and gooey. Okay, not bad. There's a lot of flavour in there, and if you look under the cheese, there's a nice amount of caramelised onion for extra flavour. Spanish sausage. This looks strong, so if you're on a date, it's probably not the best choice if you want to get romantic after. But there's a good portion size, and it goes really well with the other dishes and the alcohol. I have places to be and more food to eat, so I better finish this quickly. When I say quickly, I mean as quick as I can. I realise now that this is very slow. I'll improve though as time goes on. A few minutes walk down the road is The Beagle. It's a mild day and the sun is out, so this place looks super inviting. The Beagle is a bar and restaurant that sells Nell's Pizza, which has 3 branches in Manchester and have grown in popularity amongst the pizza lovers in the area. Like Mary and Archie, you can order at the bar or you can order at the table. This place looks busy, so I'll go for the latter. I'm lazy like that. You can order a full pizza or just buy the slice. I'll be ordering slices and I'll go for the original cheese and the mushroom at £2.50 and £3.25. I'll also order a few drinks, an orange amaretto milk stout for £6 and another half a Schafferhofer but grapefruit this time. Oh hang on, why are they the same size? I ordered a pint of the milk stout, didn't I? Oh what the hell, I only ordered a half and it cost £6? Wow. Well I guess that makes sense because looking closer, it's 10.2%. That's crazy strong. Oh wow, what a smell. I'm almost drunk off the fumes already. I'm sure it tastes okay though. Holy crap, it tastes like strong medicine, but I like it. Oh Schafferhofer, I can't go wrong with you. Lovely. Well, look at the size of this. I almost don't care how it tastes. For the price, it's pretty good so far. Oh yeah, it's crispy, chewy and full of flavour. It's savoury and the perfect accompaniment to my super expensive stout. The base is flat and crispy and it looks almost as if it's sourdough. It's amazing. The original cheese, however, this is something else. I like this one even more. The cheese and sauce on the top is generous. I wish I'd ordered 2 of this. Okay, time to finish up and move on. Or maybe not. The weather's still nice and the atmosphere is great. I can have a bit more. I fancy another slice of pizza and another drink. This time I'll try the Hogan's Blackcurrant Cider at £6. As before, it's delicious. I definitely can't get bored of eating this. Let's try the cider. It looks good. Smells good. Oh wow, I can feel it dissolving my teeth. It's super sour. Okay, it's time for me to make a move. Again, I'm going down the road, this time to a brewski bar. The place is super busy, but they've found me a table outside under a patio heater. I've ordered myself a hooch, which is a proper old man's drink at £4, and a pilsner at £4.80. I don't think I've had a hooch in over 20 years. It tastes of a misspent youth. Delicious. Pilsner is actually quite good, and I think it will go well with the snack. I haven't ordered anything too big to eat as I'm not that hungry, so I chose the poutine. It's £6.50 and it's basically skin on fries, cheese curds and gravy. It's quite gooey and savoury and it's perfect with beer. Looking a bit closer, the cheese curds are large chunks amongst the fries that are half melted. It's quite a lot actually, so the amount is generous. It's nothing mind-blowing, but the atmosphere is great. I'll come back here again and try more of their menu in future. These are just a few places I visited that day in Chorlton to make what was a great date night. There are, however, many other places. A stone's throw from Marinachi is a Thirsty Korean. This place has a lot in the way of ambience and what looks to be a number of students keen to experience Korean dining. I was a bit disappointed by the beer menu. There was no Asian beer available, so I chose this Malaga. It was tasty, however, and surprisingly crisp, which is what I'd expect. I ordered the fried chicken. 3 drumsticks and 3 wings for £14.30. To be honest, I think this is expensive, but I suppose I need to try to see whether it's value for money. You can tell it's just come out of the fryer, it's super hot. Not only does it burn my fingers, but it burns my mouth. It's not bad, there's a lot of flavour in the batter, and the sauce is really nice, but I wish the drumstick was cooked more so it came off the bone easier. The wing looks to be a bit better, and actually, it's quite delicious. Don't get me wrong, even though it's not perfect, this place has plenty of charm and I enjoyed myself. I'll be back here to try more in future. Again, nearby there's 99 Reasons, which is a beer and bagel joint. I'm here for brunch on a weekend and the place is buzzing. They have a wide menu of which to choose from and I'm going to order a cappuccino at £2.90 and a New York bagel at £7.50. The cappuccino tastes really good. It's quite pleasant and I like the cup it comes in. The bagel's quite pretty with a generous salad and they've put a decent amount of cheese and pastrami inside. Okay, wow, it's really good. The dough is soft and chewy with a hint of crispiness and the fillings work well together. I really like the ambience here and I think it can even come back and work on my editing on my laptop in future. Chorlton is crazy for places to eat and drink. I could make 100 videos if I had the time and the money. Another worthy couple of mentions for this video are Smoke and Shogun Ramen. I didn't have time to make full videos of these places as I just wanted to sit and enjoy the ambience, but as you can see from the videos, there really is something here for everyone. Whether you want to come and have a bite for lunch or you want to come and eat a late night bowl of ramen, you won't be disappointed. I don't know why, but at times when I'm eating food or drinking in these places, it feels like I'm in another place entirely. I guess that's why I keep coming back out and trying food. It's a great way to escape. I'd love to hear your feedback, and I'm happy that you keep coming and watching my videos. Thank you. Until next time, bye!